GB49ARAY 3000830113230 1 sort code 300083 Swift BIC code ARAY GB22. Please confirm your contribution at support@peacetv.tv.
Support Peace TV, the solution for humanity.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to a new episode of The Straight Path. I'm your host, Fuad Muhammad. Ramadan is the month of the Quran. And how can we use Ramadan to understand the principles and to understand the objectives of why we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And how can we synchronize both of the meanings of worship and Quran? That is our topic today on The Straight Path. And we have our guest with us today, Dr. Muhammad Saeed, who is a professor at the world-renowned Al-Azhar University. Assalamu alaikum, doctor, and welcome to The Straight Path.
Alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
It's good to have you back. Mentioning that of all the tips and all the advices, I mean, if we look at even into Islamic media, Islamic radio, magazines, everyone at the time of Ramadan, they try to come out with all the aspects that we can benefit from Ramadan. However, and we've spoken about these topics not only in this show but all the other shows about the concept of the Quran and Ramadan. Let us concentrate on the first segment, Sheikh, if you can help us to understand what is really the relationship. Of course, we know that the Quran was revealed in this holy month, but what really we can benefit from the Quran in terms of Ramadan?
First of all, I would like to say that Ramadan is a month of the Quran. Mm-hmm. Since the Prophet received the first torch of guidance, which illuminated the whole universe, mm-hmm. during the nights of Ramadan, when Jibreel came to the Prophet وسلم, and squeezed him and asked him to read, then the Prophet وسلم, said, I'm illiterate, I cannot read. Since that minute, the Prophet وسلم, had a very direct and close relationship with Jibreel and with the Quran itself. Mm-hmm. So the Prophet ﷺ, when he was detached from Jibreel for a while, he felt very sad. Mm-hmm. Until it is reported that the Prophet ﷺ used to go to the mountains of Mecca, waiting and awaiting for Jibreel to ascend again.
Yes.
Until he saw him, and Jibreel revealed to the Prophet ﷺ, after a lapse of time, of pause, mm-hmm. he revealed to him, وَالضُّحَى وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا سَجَى مَا وَدَّعَكَ رَبُّكَ وَمَا قَلَى. So the Prophet ﷺ rejoiced and he said, Allahu Akbar, Allah is the most great. Later the Prophet ﷺ, when he communicated with Jibreel, he used to rush into receiving the Quran in his heart. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this is out of mercy and this is out of anxiety to receive more of the mercy of Allah, because Quran is mercy. Mm-hmm. So the Prophet ﷺ rushed to repeat. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him, لا تحرك به لسانك لتعجل به. Don't move your tongue to be in haste. Mm-hmm. It's up to us to inculcate or to put it in your heart.
Yes.
And later the Prophet ﷺ, immediately before his death, he used to actually received the whole portion of the Quran that he received from Jibreel during the month of Ramadan. Mm-hmm. Until in the last 2 years, he received the Ahruf al-Sab'a, the 7 modes of recitation during the month of Ramadan.
Yes.
That had a reflection to the Prophet ﷺ. So the heart of the Prophet ﷺ was very related to the month of Ramadan through the Quran.
Yes.
So Ibn Abbas explained and he noticed that in the character of the Prophet ﷺ, in the authentic hadith of Sahih al-Bukhari, in which he said, إن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كان أجود الناس. Prophet ﷺ was the most generous person. وكان أجود ما يكون في رمضان. And he was most generous during the month of Ramadan. حين يأتيه جبريل فيدارسه الوحي. When Jibril used to come to the Prophet ﷺ and he used to communicate with him and study with him the Quran. Look at the word يدارسه. In Arabic it means that he teaches and he receives, he recites, and Jibril recites also. So there is an interactivity.
Yes.
And then Ibn Abbas said, فَلَرَسُولُ اللَّهِ أَجْوَدُ بِالْرِّيحِ مِنَ الْخَيْرِ الْمُرْسَلَةِ The Prophet ﷺ during those minutes is more generous than the wind. The wind doesn't have a direction. It doesn't actually give air to a direction on the other side. No, it is in every direction, everywhere, everywhere. So the Prophet ﷺ was most generous. This is the reflection of the Quran. When the wahy or the revelation, the knowledge of Allah and the words are poured in his heart and his mind, this is reflected in his behavior.
Yes.
This is reflected in the acts of righteousness, which is given in every direction to everybody. The mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is even actually given through the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Yes.
It explains how revelation and how the Quran was not only the recitation of the Quran or understanding it, the blessings of the Quran were put in his heart, and all of that was translated in the Prophet's action. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
You mentioned something there that I've never thought about, Sheikh, is that you said it's not only the recitation, the memorization, it's also the blessing of the Quran. Many of us are sometimes carried away with the concept of this, of the blessings of the Quran. We don't really understand really very deeply what the blessings of the Quran is. Since we're talking about the Quran, if you can just give us some examples of how the Quran can have that effect on the person's morality, spirituality, how the Quran can help, of course, through Allah, but how can the person use the Quran in order to improve himself?
Fortunately, my brother, that nowadays, the Muslims took the Quran just for decoration. They take the Quran just for repetition. Recitation is very important.
Yes.
It's just one word, not only one word, it's just a letter of the Quran is counts 10 good deeds up to 700, according to the authentic hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But at the same time, we forgot that the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala changed the face of humanity in just 23 years. First, there is a glory of the Quran. The Muslims nowadays, they miss the type of glory, and this glory is taken from the glory of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ta'zeemullah, glorification of Allah. I'll give you example. When the revelation, how the process went on, it is reported in Sahih al-Bukhari. And when the Jibreel actually, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the permission to a portion of the Quran to reveal, he announced that for Jibreel. Jibreel comes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and receives it in the highest heavens. So it is resemble, it's like a chain falling on a rock. It has a resounding sound, an echo on the heavens and on the earth until the angels fell in coma. They could not realize the meaning of what is revealed to Jibreel through Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala out of fear of Allah, out of glorifying Him. حَتَّى إِذَا فُزِّعَ عَنْ قُلُوبِهِمْ When the fear is removed, قَالُوا مَاذَا قَالَ رَبُّكُمْ What your Lord has revealed. قَالُوا الْحَقِّ He said the truth. He spoke the truth. So number one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about in the Quran. There is an effect of the Quran on the skin. There is an effect of the Quran on the mind, on the heart, on the limbs. How on the skin? Allah said, اللَّهُ نَزَّلَ أَحْسَنَ الْحَدِيثِ كِتَابًا مُتَشَابِهًا مَثَانِيَ تَقْشَعِرُّ مِنْهُ جُلُودُ الَّذِينَ يَخْشَوْنَ رَبَّهُ
Subhanallah.
The skin of the people who fear Allah is deeply affected by that. Because when the name of Allah is mentioned, you can test your heart. And that's why Abu Bakr as-Siddiq could not survive until he shed the tears during the prayers out of just listening to the words of Allah. So this is a deep impact of the words. It's like honey being poured in the ears. So this glorification pierces into the heart.
Mm-hmm.
So when it pierces into the heart, the mind must understand the message, because it is a message. There is no problem on the face of the earth, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala got a solution for you,
mm-hmm.
and a message for you in His book. And this is a source of guidance for the jinn and the humans, for everybody, for the woman, for the man, for the kid, for the believer, for the unbeliever. It's a universal message for everybody. Understanding this message, this is the next step to take it for sami'na wa ata'na.
Mm-hmm.
We listen and we obey. This is the influence of the Quran.
Mm-hmm.
Look how the Quran affected the Sahaba of the Prophet
ﷺ.
Nowadays we talk to the brothers and sisters, a lot of people, they are smoking. People, they cannot quit drinking. People cannot quit bad habits.
Yes.
Although Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed a prohibition about it in the Quran.
Mm-hmm.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in the Quran, كُلِّ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَغُضُّ مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِمْ وَيَحْفَظُوا فُرُوجَهُمْ. Tell the believing men to lower their gaze and to protect their private parts.
Mm-hmm.
How can we respond to it?
Okay, inshallah, we'll take a short break here on the straight path and we'll be back right after this.
Now my world is bright, Islam is my sight.
Pearls of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, reported Allah's Messenger, may peace be upon him, as saying, a believing man should not hate his believing wife. If he dislikes one of her characteristics, he will be pleased with another. Sahih Muslim, Volume 2, Book of Marriage, Hadith number 3469.
Scientific notions in the glorious Quran are among its endless aspects that can testify for the divine nature of this noble book. These scientific notions are probably the best addressed to the people of our time.
I am Zaghloul An-Najjar. Please join me in this program to discuss some aspects of the scientific notions in the glorious Quran.
He created the universe.
Appreciate the word-to-word authenticity of scientific notions and proven facts mentioned in the glorious Quran 1400 years ago in Scientific Notions in the Glorious Quran. Next on Peace TV.
Now my world is bright, Islam is my sign.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back. You're watching The Straight Path. We're still talking to Dr. Mohammed Said, who's a professor in Al-Azhar University. Point that you're making there about having the effect, and the Sahabas really enjoying that benefit of having effect, the effect of the Quran upon them. What was it based on? Why is it that we can't read the same Quran and listen to the same Quran and have the same effect? What's the difference? Because people might say, oh, Ya Sheikh, stop right there. The Sahabas were different people. They were in the company of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Now we're in the company of people, some of the people we can't trust who are reading the Quran. How do you expect us to have that effect? What is your answer to that?
The answer is given in the hadith of Jarir ibn Abdullah. And he said, he explained for us the difference between us and the Sahaba. The Sahaba received Iman first, before knowledge. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showered and filled their hearts with Iman. And they had ready bottles to fill it with the Quran. So when the Quran came, it increased their knowledge and increased their iman. So number one, we need to evacuate our hearts from the dirt of this dunya. Purify our hearts to receive the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How? To dedicate ourselves, to intensively concentrate on the message of Allah. Number three, to have an open heart, to say, yes, we submit and we obey without discussion. Out of your pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is very important. And increasing iman has a lot of ways. Making umrah may increase your iman. Fasting increases your iman. Making prayers during the nights. Sincerity, telling the truth, saying, abiding by Allah's laws. All of this increases the iman. So once you have that increased iman, you have the readiness to receive the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is represented in the Quran. In 1993, they passed the bill in the United States to ban alcohol. And after passing this bill, they noticed that the people increased the dosages of receiving alcohol. And they could not actually quit it. Simply, and they even had a hygienic consequences about it. Like, for example, people used to hide and to do it. So it is a problem. If you compare it, so they failed. And they tolerated it again, and they changed the law. If you compare it to one ayah revealed in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنَّمَا الْخَمْرُ وَالْمَيْسُرُ وَالْأَنصَابُ وَالْأَزْلَامُ رِجْسٌ مِّنْ عَمَلِ الشَّيْطَانِ فَاجْتَنِبُوهُ. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed and said, wine, drinking, ansab, altars, and gambling are rijs, are filth of the shaitan, so abandon it. The word abandon it, this had a great influence on the hearts of the Sahaba, and they quit immediately until the narrator said it was like riverlets falling in Medina out of the jars which were split of wine. When the believing women, we nowadays, we are calling our sisters, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fill iman in the hearts of all of our viewers, and of all the Muslims, and to increase it and to resurrect all in the Jannah, Ya Rab. The believing women at that time, when the ayah of hijab, the verse telling them to veil, was revealed, they did not have the opportunity to go home. They cut some of the clothes into pieces and they started to cover themselves. Response to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When the Qibla was changed from Jerusalem to the Kaaba, people were praying. It's just a messenger of the messenger of Allah coming to them and telling them while they were bound down during the prayer of Asr. Inna Rasulallahi uhi ilayhi, the Prophet ﷺ received a revelation to turn his face to the Kaaba. They did not wait to verify. They did not wait to tell him, who are you? How? What is the ayah? What is the proof? They turned with their imam to the other direction, moving all the way to the other side. So this is a kind of response. There are a lot of barriers, a lot of barriers that keeps us from activating with the Quran, acting upon the Quran. On the top of them, lack of understanding. We do not understand the Quran. We just repeat it without understanding it. That's why Ibn al-Qayyim, when he explained the hadith, because the Prophet ﷺ will come on the Day of Judgment.
So we were mentioning how the effect of the Quran upon the companions of the Prophet ﷺ, and you said the basis of this was their iman. Before anything, they had the complete full faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then this with constant ibadah and listening to the Quran and so forth, this helped them to reap the benefits from the Quran. Let's look at the concept you mentioned of barriers. What are some of the barriers for us not to benefit from the Quran? You said that the root of it is lack of understanding.
Exactly. And how the Sahaba also reflected to the Quran? They reflected because the Quran was revealed according to the occasions, mm-hmm. according to the circumstances that they lived in, mm-hmm. according to the environment. Mm-hmm. So it was engraved in their hearts and in their minds. So we had a lot of stories, which is commonly known as Asbab al-Nuzul, the occasions of revelations. So we need to have, number one, a lot of reading of the Book of Allah, mm-hmm. especially during the month of Ramadan.
Yes.
Al-Shafi'i used to recite the whole Quran twice in the day and the night.
SubhanAllah.
Once in the day and once in the night. Others used to recite it, it's preferable, according to the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, according to the hadith of Abdullah ibn Amr, to recite it each 3 days. This is the maximum pace that a person can do the Quran. Why? Because the Prophet ﷺ said, and if you recite it in less than that, you will not be able to understand the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So one of the barriers is lack of understanding, mm-hmm. abandoning the understanding. Ibn al-Qayyim was talking about the complaint that the Prophet ﷺ will raise on the Day of Judgment, and it's mentioned in the Quran. وَقَالَ الرَّسُولُ يَا رَبِّ إِنَّ قَوْمِ اتَّخَذُوا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ مَهْجُورًا. The Prophet ﷺ will complain on the Day of Judgment to Allah, saying, my people took this Quran abandoned. They took it abandoned. Mm-hmm. So they received it, and then they abandoned it.
Mm-hmm.
And Al-Qayyim said, people abandon the Quran by leaving its recitation, mm-hmm. neglecting proper understanding of its message and translating it into action. So one of the barriers is that we do not read tafsir of the Quran. We do not correlate the Quran to our needs and dire necessities or the necessities in our life. We don't have a link between the Quran and our real life. We hear a lot of dua, a lot of people, they talk and they quote a lot of the Quran verses, and they don't find solutions for the people's problems nowadays. The Quran was a solution, is still a solution. And the Prophet ﷺ said, تَرَكْتُ فِيكُمْ مَا إِن تَمَسَّكْتُمْ بِهِ لَن تَضِلُّ بَعْدِ أَبَدًا. I left behind me two things, if you keep hold of, you will never ever feel astray. One of them is the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
Okay, doctor, I don't want to interrupt what you're saying, but you just mentioned that there's a point that some of us might see a bit conflicting. What is it? Is that you said it's encouraged to read the Quran much more in Ramadan. And you know, it's a tradition now between us Muslims that we only concentrate on reading the Quran in Ramadan. And then after Ramadan, we wait until the next Ramadan. You understand what I'm saying?
No.
So it's like, you're concentrating all the effort in 1 month, and then for 11 months, you don't do anything actually. And then we wait on the next Ramadan to concentrate on recitation again. Can this have a negative effect in terms of how can the Quran reach us when we just dedicate that 1 month towards it?
Surely because we did not receive the enough dosage of love of the Book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is one of the barriers that mm-hmm. keeps us away from the Quran, that we do not have a continuous and consistent relationship with the Book of Allah. We should have a word. Mm-hmm. Word means a portion of the Quran that must mm-hmm. be recited every day.
And what's the recommendation to
be recommended? The Prophet ﷺ recommended to finish the whole Quran maybe in 10 nights. The mm-hmm. Sahaba used actually to finish it in 7 nights.
Mm-hmm.
Others, they can in 10. Or at least you can finish one juz a day. Mm-hmm. So it is 30 juz a month. Mm-hmm. And the Prophet ﷺ said, if you don't do it, so you abandon the Book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You must have a retrieval system, mm-hmm. a retrieval system of reading the Quran. You must also have, if you are able, to recite the Quran and to memorize it. If you are not able, and some of our audience actually, they only speak English, they should learn the Arabic alphabet and know how to read the Quran along with the translation.
This is a must.
It is necessary, it's obligatory, because mm-hmm. we use the Quran during the prayer. If you are not able even to do this, don't wait. Just rush to the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and take the benefit of the Quran and read a translation of the meaning of the Book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala right away, even if one portion a day. You must have that kind of feeling with the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on it. So this, it breeds love for his book.
Yeah. Because if you really look at it, doctor, because if someone doesn't read the Quran for the entire year, and then he tries to finish the Quran 3 or 4 times in Ramadan, it's really a big effort because he's not accustomed to it, first of all. And then at the end of Ramadan, he feels so much burden on reading the Quran, so that he takes a rest that keeps him until the next Ramadan.
So it is recommended to be like Ar-Rahil Murtahil in Arabic. Mm-hmm. Ar-Rahil Murtahil means a rider. When he stops, he resumes the journey again.
Mm-hmm.
So don't stop, never stop. When you finish قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ, you start with Al-Fatiha and Al-Baqarah, and you move in the blessed journey of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by day and night. And also it is recommended to use the Quran in your prayers. When you memorize a portion, try to actually read it during your prayer.
Mm-hmm.
And teach it to the kids. Because the Prophet ﷺ said, خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ وَعَلَّمَ. The best amongst you is the one who teaches the Quran and learns it.
JazakAllah khair, doctor. That's Dr. Muhammad Saeed there, a professor in Al-Azhar University. And I hope we can take the lessons from this episode and put it into our lives, practice it, try to make the Quran part of this Ramadan and part of it for the rest of our lives, inshallah. Till next time, I leave you with Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Now I found the light after those long dark nights. Now my world is bright. Islam is my sight. Now I found the light after those long dark nights. Now my world is bright. Islam is my sight. Now my world is bright. Islam is my sight. Now my world is bright. Islam is my sight. Oh.
The value of money in the hereafter will be measured by its proper use in the present.
Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu anfiqu mimma razaqnakum min qabli an ya'tiya yawmun la bay'un fihi wa la khullatun wa la shafa'a.
According to the glorious Quran, one of the best ways to use your money is to spend it in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by spreading His message of Islam. Peace TV is a non-profit Islamic satellite television channel that is primarily dedicated for just that cause, the proper presentation of Islam. It's a great choice to invest in it and a golden opportunity to purify your wealth in a way that pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Support Peace TV. Send your zakat and donations to IRFI Al Rayan Bank, 47 Calthorpe Road, Birmingham, UK. B151TH. Pound account number 01132301. IBAN GB49ARAY 3000830113230 1. Sort code 300083. SWIFT BIC code ARAY GB22. Please confirm your contribution at support@peacetv.tv.
Support Peace TV, the solution for humanity.
We are not addicted to dawah. Addiction implies a short-term fix. One doesn't need to get into the zone to talk about Islam. You do dawah because it is a natural result of your commitment to Allah. If you don't talk, people are going to walk. The most effective combination in the propagation of true Islam is found in Dawah Ilallah. Join me, Arif Islam, as we go through Dawah Ilallah only on Peace TV.
Follow the tips to make the task of Dawah result-oriented in Dawah Ilallah. every Sunday, Tuesday and Thursday at 11:30 p.m. and repeat telecast at 6 a.m. UK on Peace TV.